Hello friends, happy Friday. My name's Duke, and I'm on a quest to play every single Wario Land game ever made. I played Super Mario Land 1 and 2 for the Game Boy, the predecessors to Wario Land, and I'm about to jump into the first ever game starring Wario as the protagonist. Let's begin. I've never played this before. I have no idea what to expect. I sure didn't expect a pirate duck. Man, Wario is a pretty good paddler. Okay, and that's the story, apparently. Man, that poor duck. He looked pretty chill. Wario just came in and acted like a jerk. Okay, and the demo starts. Or the attract mode, since demo doesn't mean what it meant when this game came out. At the time, that was the demo. Now, demo generally means a playable demo. Alright, so similar file screen to Mario Land 2. We have three options, and we can delete a save if we want, but we don't have any saves yet. So, I don't know much about this game. I know that hats are involved in some capacity. I'm not sure how I know that. It might have been, there was a Retronauts podcast about the Wario Land series. They might have discussed the hat aspect. Or I might have seen a video or something. Okay, so the world map seems pretty similar to Mario Land 2. We have a larger map that seems to be divided into subzones. This is Rice Beach. Alright, a nice big chunky Wario sprite. Whoa. Okay, that is definitely something that Mario's never done. Can I do it in midair? No. Do I have, like, a stomping, a butt stomp attack? No. Okay. So in the previous Mario Land game, hearts were 1-ups. But I don't think... The hearts are something else down there. I have 21 of them now. Alright, so I can still... Whoa! I can jump on enemies and pick them up? Like the best of both worlds. We have the man, this is weird. Okay, so I can do that charge attack to break open these blocks. Alright, the charge attack doesn't seem to be a run button, because when I hold it down, I seem to walk at the same speed, which is interesting. I have to say, nothing about this looks like a Mario game so far. I mean, in Mario Land 1 and 2, things were definitely different from a traditional Mario game, but this looks completely different. Okay, you have coins, and you have blocks, but they look much more anthropomorphized than blocks in any other Mario game. Okay, so there's a hat, okay? That looks like it increases my charge. That's kind of interesting. Ooh, and I have like a stomping attack now. How did I do that? Okay. So that gives me a butt stomp. When I have the Viking helmet, I charge farther and I can do a stomp that seems to stun all of the enemies on the screen. Or at least the enemies I've encountered so far. The blocks look surprised before you hit them, and angry after you hit them. You think it would be the other way around. You think that they would look surprised after you hit them. And, I mean, I don't know why they would be angry. I mean, I guess I can see why they would be angry after I hit them. I'm trying to determine if I get, like, a higher jumper or something. Oh, well, that worked. When I charge. I wasn't sure if I would get hit if I... if I walked into that thing's spear or not, but I decided not to risk it. Okay, so interesting, we have a section here I wouldn't have been able to access if I didn't have the Viking helmet. I guess that's what that is. I mean, it might just be, okay, this is the same area. It might just be a generic horned helmet. I guess there's nothing inherently Viking-esque about a horned helmet. There have been other cultures that had similar horned helmet styles. Uh-oh. Oh, whoa. So this is what Tiny Wario looks like. He has like a, I don't even know what that hairstyle is. Okay, so I can't charge. He has like a Macklemore do, like the little mohawk thing. Okay. Well, I died on the first level. That's not boding well. But you know, I'm still testing the limits of what I can do as Wario. Seeing what this character's capable of. Okay. And I didn't hit a checkpoint yet, so it's back to the beginning I go. Well, maybe I can see what happens when I collect 100 of these hearts. If anything happens when I collect 100 of them. I guess I lost all my coins when I died. I saw coins like fly out of Wario, but I wasn't sure if that meant anything, but it looks like I lost all of them. So here's my guess. My guess is that the hearts are like a currency, kind of like the coins in Super Mario Land 2, where instead of collecting 100 of them to get an extra life, you could collect up to 1,000 and then turn them in at the slot machine. So I figure hearts might serve that same purpose, and then it has the traditional 100 coin extra life mechanic that a normal Mario game would have. Oh, interesting. If I hit jump right after I do a dash, I do like... That definitely seems to be a higher jump. Or maybe it's just any time you jump while dashing, you get that little bit of extra height. So, I guess I'm about to find out what the dealy with these hearts are. Or maybe if you collect 100 of them, you get a power-up or something. Other Mario games have had mechanics like that, I think. Oh, come on. I did this a minute ago. Jeez. Okay. So, it's 100 hearts gets you a 1-up. So maybe it's the other way around. Maybe the hearts are the 1-up fodder. And then the coins are a currency that you can spend on things, on power-ups or extra lives, probably. The world map in this game doesn't seem to be as robust as the one in Super Mario Land 2, at least so far. It just kind of dropped me into the first zone. Aw, I'm not going to be able to get out of here, am I? Just kind of dropped me into Rice Beach without letting me explore any other areas. Maybe once I finish Rice Beach, then the world map will open up and I'll have access to other zones. Okay, so I just walked into that thing carrying an enemy, and it killed it. Maybe I just got lucky there. Oops. Oh wait, I can just knock these guys over by walking into them? Huh. I did not realize that. Is that something my hat's letting me do, or do I always have that ability? Okay, so when you get two of those, it doesn't upgrade your hat again. Well, this is kind of a bummer. Can I make this jump? Well, not if Spear Guy has anything to say about it. Jeez. Okay, so the spear didn't really seem to protect that guy much. Oh, maybe because I was doing the air dash, I'm invincible to weapons and stuff. I don't think I can get up there. That does not appear to be a jump I can make. Is there like a hidden block somewhere? Ah, that's a very Mario thing to do. So the air dash seems to be like an improved version of Sonic's spin jump. Because I don't know how to do this. Maybe there's like an invincibility or something around here. Because with Sonic's spin jump, you can still be hurt by like spikes and stuff. You can run into enemies with impunity. Oh, okay. So maybe I was mistaken. I thought as long as I dashed into that thing, the spear wouldn't hurt me, but apparently it does. Mechanically, this game feels a lot better than Mario Land 2 so far. Feels a little more solid. I mean, it's a little... Oh, cool. So it, okay, so I can either do... Is that a coin? I can either do the coin game or the heart game. I have 39 coins, so let's see what I can do with those. Alright, so I have 2 buckets I can choose. Well, hey, it paid off. Sweet. I guess that was a double or nothing kind of prop. Oh, so I can keep going? But it looks like I can leave anytime I want. Interesting. So it's a double or nothing every time. Oh, it's double or half, it looks like. Huh. Yep, double or half. Well, I should probably cut my losses and get out of here. Okay, I'm not sure what those letters represent. Alright, well, that was very interesting. I'll have to see what the heart game is next time. I have to say, that's not the most interesting bonus minigame I've ever played, but, kind of fits with the Wario theme. It seems like later Wario games have this theme of, like, collecting as much treasure as possible, like getting as many coins as you can, amassing a fortune. That seems to be Wario's MO. Aw, man. Bummer. Alright, so what is this? Well, I guess I can't activate it when I'm small. I have to say, Wario's faux hawk is pretty hilarious. Or, I don't know, it might be an actual mohawk. It's hard to tell with this level of resolution. Boy, tiny Wario seems pretty vulnerable. I can't open this box. Well, I guess I can do that. Jump into it from below. Can't get up there. At least it doesn't look like I can. Well, I don't know, maybe... Maybe I need to get hit and die. Okay, well, we're still learning. I probably won't be this bad at the game the whole time, hopefully. Alright, I need to take the high road this time so I can see what that door up there held. Okay, so can I activate this box now? No. Can I stomp on it? No. Okay, so it's just a foreboding skull box. Good to know. Pretty good music so far. Very... Aw. I tried to time it, so I jumped onto that second platform, but didn't make it. Alright, well, try again. Very reminiscent of Mario Land 2 so far. Which makes sense. Alright, so that's a solid platform. Alright, I need to watch these and get the timing down. More hearts, always nice. Oh, new hat! Holy crap! What the heck is this game? Wow. That is... Oh. Oh, interesting. It has a defense mechanism. And I can't seem to torch it. Or at least I can't torch it when it's inflated. Continuing the tradition of really cute enemies from Mario Land 2. I like this thing. Alright, so I can duck, but I still... Aww. Bogus. I didn't think it would bounce me that high. Oh well. Oh, it is a mohawk. Look at that. Wow, that is so weird. Did that thing just die when it touched me? Oh, man. Right in the butt. Well, I haven't noticed any sort of checkpoint mechanic in this game so far. Like, Wario Land... Or Mario Land 2 had the bell, which served as, like, the midpoint of the level. Haven't seen anything like that in this game yet. Hopefully something like that shows up. But now that I know what I'm doing, I can get back to where I was pretty quickly, I think. I don't know if I want this hat. Alright, so I can definitely torch those things. When they're small. I just, they need to be on a higher plane than me. Alright, so I can't butt stomp it. Am I sure I can't torch it when it's inflated? No, I guess not. Okay. Oh, man. I was hoping it wouldn't notice me. Oh well. Alright, so that thing definitely died when the bottom part of it hit my head. At least I think it did. I don't know. Okay, it did. That's so weird. The top of my head is like... Is my mohawk a weapon of some sort? Am I reverse stomping on the enemies? I don't know. Alright, can I trigger this or activate it or something? I'm doing something to it. Oh, okay, there we go. Right, so what did that do? The door was already open. So weird, can I always do that? Oh, I guess so. Can I throw coins at enemies? I guess so, wow. This game is surprising me in many different ways so far. Oh, out of coins. Oh, so that must be what that... I heard that beep-beep noise earlier. Like I was unable to do something, but I wasn't sure what that was. I wonder if you can throw coins when you're small. Because I think I hit up and it didn't seem to do anything. Aw. Okay, well, I can just jump back up there. That's good. Alright, so still just the two types of hats so far. Oh, wait, can I torch this thing? Is that how I... No, I guess not. Okay, when I get this hat, I can no longer do the butt stomp, which is kind of sad. But I guess this attack is way better than a butt stomp. Oh, cool, I can find hidden blocks with this as well? That sure seems to be what happened. Aw, I killed that bird. Alright, so this one, I definitely need to activate myself. Oh, okay, so each of those represents 10 coins. That's interesting. So if I don't have 10 coins when I get here, I guess I have to backtrack and find 10 coins. Okay, well, I only have 3 coins this time, so let's see what the heart game is all about. It won't let me play it. That's weird. Do I need to have... Well, if I have 100, it'll just... It'll reset the counter. Do I need, like, 99 of those or something? No. Okay, so this is the same game. Probably not worth playing when I only have 3 coins. I guess it rounds down when it takes half your coins. Well, I only have 1 left. What the heck? Alright. I doubled my money. I want Wario to get hit by a weight again, just so... I love that sad face. Oh, so you can only play it 3 times. Okay. I thought he started moving to the left automatically, but I wasn't sure. Oh, okay. So by winning coins in the minigame, I guess I can unlock things. That's what those letters are. That's interesting. I wonder how many coins I need to unlock the first thing. Wonder why it wouldn't let me play the heart game. That's weird. I like how it calls them courses. That's sort of an old school Mario touch that I enjoy. I don't think... Did I make that jump? I'm not sure. Nope. Oh, I see. I can swim in the waterfall. Sort of. Alright, got my hat back. Heck yeah! I wonder if there's a power-up that just makes you Big Wario again. Aw. Doesn't give you a hat of any kind. Okay, so I have to mash the button pretty good to maintain any altitude here. I think it looks like an enemy from your version, kind of. A cool indie game that came out a few years ago. Alright, very, very... Okay, so I can still throw coins. Interesting. But I don't have any at the moment. So that's cool. The coins are like a multifunctional currency. They're a weapon and they're a key to open doors and unlock different areas of the game. And they're also used in the bonus game to unlock things there. Okay, so I have some branching paths here. I was going to go on ahead because I figured I would get a dead end, but it doesn't look like it, so let's try this the first door first. Okay, well, I have my 10 coins, so let's see what this does. I don't know. Presumably it unlocked some kind of door somewhere. Okay, so that just goes back into the same area. Alright, so that's still activated. So whatever it is, it's activated permanently. Or at least for the rest of this level. Aw, no way to get in here. Bummer. Unless... Nope. Have to have 10 coins, or you can't throw any. Hey, here's some coins. I'm assuming I can break those blocks by throwing coins at them. I don't think I've really tested that yet. But I mean, it makes sense. Because how else is Baby Wario supposed to do anything? Oh, but if I do, I won't even be able to get that block. That sucks. Well, let's try going back down and see if I can break that block that was restricting my access to go further down. Doesn't look like it. I guess it hits enemies only. Can I collect it after I throw it? Looks like I might have been able to if I can get it fast enough, but I'm not sure. Oh no! Oh, okay. That's the thing. Good. Man, hearts are good. Oh, I got a 1-up. That's. Oh, here we go. Hat. Oh, okay, so that's just the normal Wario. Big hat. You know, maybe Wario always has a mohawk. It just, he's usually wearing his hat so you can't see it. I don't know. From the looks of his hair, like, unless that's a shadow, it doesn't look like he keeps the mohawk as Big Wario. Maybe that's like, quicksand or something. or sand. It reminds me of in Sonic and Knuckles in the Sandopolis zone. Oh yeah, that's right, I can charge again. Sweet. There are sand waterfalls that function pretty much exactly like this. And I think this game predates Sonic and Knuckles by quite a few years. Huh. Wonder if I can jump up here and use that as a platform to get further up. I don't know if I'll be able to make this jump or not. Oh, I can't stand on it anyway. I thought I could. That's weird. It looks like there's more up there, but I don't know how to get to it. Huh. I guess this is going to be the end of this level. Looks like there are definitely secrets that I'm still not sure how to uncover. Alright, well, I only have 2 coins again, so we'll... Nope, still can't do the heart game. I don't know what the deal with that is. I wish I had more coins to throw into the bucket, because I'd really like to see what I can unlock by playing this. Hopefully more hats. Most people don't know that the Wario games are actually the predecessors to Team Fortress 2. Sad Wario. Well, hey, at least I add my 1 coin to it. I wonder if you go into that minigame and you don't play, you just dump coins into it. I wonder if that works, or I wonder if you actually have to play the mini game to add coins to your total. Oh crap, your total stockpile. Man, I'd be in trouble if I wasn't big here. There's like an ambulatory thwomp threatening to thwomp me. I'm sure it can't climb ladders though. That's just ridiculous, right? That was a joke. Aw man, a dragon hat would really let me get through this place a lot more quickly. A what? I thought that was just water. I guess the way it was rolling and boiling should have been a tip-off, huh? Not sure what I'm going to have to do when I get to that point again. I didn't see any other way to go. See, this is an example. One example of a lack of color being a detriment. Because if I could see that stuff was red, which I'm sure it would be if this was an NES game, then that would have been a pretty clear hint that I couldn't jump in there. But yes, the whole boiling aspect. Should have. Oh, I see. I just have to jump in here and wait for the thwomp to cook itself. Looks like I can actually stand on top of it, too. Because there are no spikes there. So I guess I have to ride this thing. Very interesting. Oh, no! Very interesting level design in this game so far. But, you know, I didn't expect anything less. Is that a new hat? Aw, man! I got so fixated on the hat. Doesn't seem to be at any checkpoints so far. Which is weird. This game doesn't seem to go easy on you. But of course, I guess after Wario's castle, you know, that should have been expected. Because, man, Wario's Castle at the end of Super Mario Land 2. If you didn't watch that LP, go back and watch that episode at least. Because that was a real, real drag. Luckily, the controls in this game don't seem to be nearly as weird and floaty as the ones in that game. But really, that level wouldn't have been as hard as it was if it wasn't for the weird floaty controls. It's a lot dumber looking than a thwomp, to be honest. I mean, I hate to be mean, but looks pretty dumb. Those bats are pretty cute, though. I like the little fangs. Nope. Wow, I lost all 26 of my coins. I mean, I guess it makes sense. They don't want you, like, dying over and over again. Saving up coins. I mean, if it didn't take all of your coins, then I imagine you could game the coin game at the end pretty easily. Of course, I don't know how the continue system in this game works. Hopefully, it doesn't kick me back to the beginning of Rice Beach. It hasn't said that it saved the game yet, but it might just be an autosave thing after every level. All right, I need to be more careful. I need to not get fixated on hitting the blocks. The first block is just hearts. I can pretty much just ignore that one. I do want to get that second one though and see what that hat does. It looks different than the hats I've gotten so far. It might be a hat that gives me like a floaty kind of jump, which would be helpful in this situation. All right. I need to remember that holding that button doesn't let you run, so there's no reason to actually push that button unless I want to charge. You kind of have to unlearn behaviors from other Mario games. Like, there's no run, so there's no need to hold the button down all the time. But you know, that's kind of just, that's ingrained in you from playing Mario. If you're about to make a tricky jump, hold down that run button to get as much momentum as possible. But this game doesn't work. Oh well, at least I should get a 1-up pretty soon. Which won't do me a lot of good if I die and go back to the beginning. That would really suck. I'd have to like edit out me getting back to this level. Cause I don't want you guys to have to watch me play through the whole thing over again. Hopefully it won't be that mean though. I'm pretty sure Mario Land 2 wasn't that mean. That there was actual like checkpointing. Not like in level, I mean there was in level checkpointing, but there was also like, if you lose all your lives, it's pretty generous about what levels you have to play over again. Okay, I was going to get on top of that thing. Okay, that's just the horns, so never mind. And I mean, it's not like better hats give you extra hit points or anything. So there was really no reason for me to have to get that. Aw man, I was hoping it would stop. But nope, it's not over yet. That bull helmet, or the Viking helmet, whatever it was, might be a bull helmet. I mean, that would make sense because it lets you charge farther. You know, charge like a bull. But maybe it lets you charge through multiple layers of blocks. Alright, I was just curious if that thing would do anything else. But it just kinda went along its merry way. Alright, now they're acting like thwomps. I like that the enemies are vulnerable to the thwomps. That's kinda cool. Did that thing drop a tenner? Oh, interesting. So that's actually good to let it do that, because otherwise they don't drop coins like that, or they don't drop coins in multiples of 10. Do those things respawn? No, I guess not. That would be another way to really game the system. All right. I don't know what it wants from me. Oh wait. Oh. So this game still uses coins. You just have to have at least 20 coins to play this game. Interesting. Alright, well, I can't afford the A course, so let's go with the B course. Let's see what this is all about. Alright, so I have 5 bombs. Ready. Go. I'm not ready. Oh. So it's like a shooting gallery, but with bombs. Okay, so I have to hold it down and charge up my shot. Oh, wait, no. Oh, crap. So the power meter just goes by itself, and I have to hit it with the correct timing. I still missed. Dang it. I hope I hit at least one of these. Oh, come on! The duck walked right through that explosion. Bull Pucky. Nope. I was trying to do it. Oh, I see. So if I hit all five of them, I would have gotten a 3-up. Alright, well, that was a waste of 40 coins. That's a little disappointing, but that's interesting. Okay, so it still puts my remaining coins towards this treasure screen. Wow. That is a 5-digit number. Meaning I can potentially get up to 99,999 of these suckers. Hopefully I won't need that many, because at this rate, it'll take me quite a while to accumulate that many. Maybe you're meant to do like multiple playthroughs or something. There's like a new game plus where you keep the amount of coins you have in there. But I don't know what treasure could be worth doing that. Wow, I can even pick up this brute. Trying to figure out how to actually kill these things. I guess just toss them against a wall. Hi, Thwomp. Alright. So let's see if my bull theory was correct. Nope. I can still just take out one of these at a time. That sucks. It would be fun to charge through multiples. Hey, come back here, you. I want you to be Thwomped. Because I want those 10 coins. That's kind of cool. The game rewards you for thinking outside the box, sort of. So now I want to go back and collect as many coins as I can. Now that I know that they're kind of important. See, it seems kind of like Dark Souls, to be honest. And I'm not just saying that because I've been playing a lot of Dark Souls lately, but there really is kind of a parallel there. Because, I mean, you get them from killing enemies, you lose them if you die, you lose all of them if you die, and you can spend them on upgrades. Well, I don't know how to get through here. Oh, okay. You just have to walk into it and you just automatically do that. Oh, okay. I don't have to be up against a wall to do that. I can crawl like that anytime I want. Interesting. So what do I get for activating this? This must be like the game's... Oops! Oh, maybe this is the checkpoint. I was going to say it's like the game's equivalent of a bonfire. Just as a joke. But that might be exactly what it is. I don't want to have to die and find out if I'm right. Oh, you can't even open these blocks by butt stomping them. See, is that the... Okay. So the one with the little horns is just the Viking helmet. The one that looks like it but without the horns is the just the Wario, normal big Wario hat. And then the one that looks kind of like a dragon is the dragon hat. That seems to be the three that I'm working with so far. Aw, man, how do I get in there? Is that like ice that I need the dragon hat to melt? I'm not sure. Doesn't seem to be giving me a dragon hat. Well, let's see if there's a dragon hat in here. Hopefully those hearts don't disappear. Oh, okay. Very cool. So you can go in there and change the layout of the level. All right, boss time. What is that? That moved pretty fast. Oh man, it burrowed under the sand. Well, I can't just jump on him. Oh. Definitely can't jump on him there. Huh? At least now I get to test my checkpoint theory. Yes, excellent. So everything in this game costs coins. See, that's kind of unfortunate because now I don't get the coins that I would have collected by going through the whole level again. Aw, man. Oh, crap, I saw that coming too. So you know, it's a trade-off. You don't have to play up to the checkpoint again, but you lose out on all those coins. And there's no way to do a corpse run and get those coins back. At least the hearts respawn. That's nice of it. Alright, bird boy. Meet Bull Boy. I think you're gonna like him. Still not quite sure what to do about this guy. Maybe I just need to be more patient, wait for him to reveal a vulnerability. Maybe when it was upside down like that, I should have jumped on him then. Maybe the belly is the weak spot. Dang it. Time to test that theory. Aw, man. Such a small window to hit him when he does that. Man, shrinking you down to tiny Wario no matter what. Pretty brutal. This game is definitely a step up in difficulty from the previous Mario Land games. Okay, that is his weak spot. Forgive my silence while I concentrate. Aw, man! Such bullcrap. Maybe I can jump into his belly with my mohawk when he does that. Okay, that works. Nice. I'm glad that works because I am rapidly running out of lives. Aw, man, I should have gotten him again. Oh well. Nice. Look at all these coins. Okay. I don't feel bad about losing all those coins now. Nice. I probably could have gotten more there. Man, I don't know if I want to play either of these. I mean, the coin game is pure luck, and the heart game is pure skill. Maybe it's easier if I do the A course. I don't know. Man, I probably shouldn't have done this because those coins would probably be better spent towards my coin hoard, to be honest. Alright, so what's the difference here? Is it slower? Is it easier to hit? Because it's a mole and not the bird? I can't tell. Crap. Wonder how much power I need to get it all the way to the other side. I have to get it in, like, the quote-unquote red zone. Yes! I actually hit something. Man, it, like, bounced before it exploded. Oh, okay. 50 up? Wow. Well, it's not quite as forgiving as the Mario minigame. or Mario Land 2 minigame that gave you 99 extra lives. I guess I'm just gonna have to get good at that game. Rice Beach has been conquered. Mount Teapot. So I guess there is no, like, open world map like there is in Mario Land 2. It's just kind of linear so far. Okay, well, I guess this will about do it for the first episode of Let's Play Wario Land. Hope you guys are enjoying it so far. Video went a little bit long. Bear with me. Hopefully, future videos, I'll have more of a handle on what I'm doing, and they won't go quite so long. But, yeah, tune in on Monday for episode 2 of Let's Play Wario Land. I'm Duke of the Bump. Goodbye.